Diodes. Our topic today is diodes. Diode is a semiconductor device that conducts current only in one direction but does not conduct current in the opposite direction. It only allows the flow of current in one direction. This is analogous to a valve, like you can see has been drawn. You have a pipe with hinges and then you have the valve. Now what happens if water was to flow through the valve in this direction? You see the water flows through, the valve opens up for the water to flow through in that direction. But if the water were to come from the opposite direction, the valve closes, preventing the water from flowing through. So that is exactly how a diode functions. It only operates in one direction, allows the flow of current in one direction as the water is allowed to flow in the direction as shown. You can see water flows only through this pipe in one direction because the valve opens up to allow the flow of water. So in the forward direction to diodes allows the flow of current. But in the reverse direction, which we are going to talk about later in this course when we're looking about biasing of diode, we can see that in the reverse direction, just as when you reverse the flow of water through the pipe, water cannot flow through the pipe. The reason is because the valve closes up, preventing water from flowing through. Now, what about the symbol of the diode? Now, you can see the symbol of the diode. It has two terminals. We have the positive anode terminal, and then you also have the negative cathode terminal. So that's the symbol of the diode shown there. That's a physical diode, also a typical physical diode. You see the labeling, the anode and the cathode. Now I want to look at applications of diodes. There are many applications of diodes. It can be used as rectifiers. Now what are rectifiers? These are diodes that help us to convert AC to DC. And then we have Zener diodes. Now what are Zener diodes? They are more or less like stabilizer diodes. They stabilize the DC voltage to avoid fluctuations of voltage supplies to the load. So that's what Zener diode does in a circuit. Apart from the rectifiers, diode acting as rectifiers and Zener, we also have wave shaping circuits as clippers, clampers and doublers. We are going to see what all of that means later on, how diode serves these capacities. We also have other applications of diode, which are LEDs. LEDs are simply light emitting diodes. They emit lights. You know, we have seen very many applications of diode in these areas. Then we also have photodiodes, which produce electric current when light falls on the diode. And then we have protection diodes. Now what are protection diodes? These are used in battery powered equipment to protect the circuit from being damaged if the polarity of the battery is accidentally reversed. Now come to biasing of a diode. Now there are two types of biasing of diodes. These two types are the forward bias, and then we also have the reverse bias of a diode. Now when we talk about forward biasing of a diode, how do we forward bias a diode? Remember we said that the diode is a two terminal device. It has a positive terminal and a negative terminal. So when we connect the positive terminal of the battery and the negative terminal of the battery to the diode, then we have it forward biased. It's analogous to a switch that is closed. So we have the circuit of the diode shown there. In this configuration, the diode is going to allow the flow of current to the resistor. So in such configuration, we say the diode is forward biased. What about reverse biasing of a diode? Now, reverse biasing a diode simply means that we interchange the terminals. We connect the negative terminal of the diode to the positive terminal and the positive terminal to the negative terminal of the battery. And in this configuration, current will not flow. It's also analogous to a switch that is opened. Of course, when you open up a switch, it is not going to allow the flow of current. And that's what you see there. And then we have the circuit connection, where you see that the positive terminal of the battery is connected to the negative terminal of the diode, and the negative terminal of the battery is connected to the positive terminal. So it will not allow the flow of current in that direction. So we can see that if you actually want the diode to function properly, it must be correctly biased. And biasing it correctly means that it should be forward biased. Positive terminal of battery to positive terminal of diode, and negative terminal of battery to negative terminal of diode. Once connected in that configuration, the diode will be able to allow the flow of current, which only flows in that direction. So we have seen in today's class what the diode is. We've seen that it's a two-terminal device, anode positive terminal and the cathode negative terminal. It's analogous to the valve that allows water to flow only in one direction. We've also seen that there are various applications of diode, which include rectifiers, convert AC to DC, Zener diode, data stabilizer circuits, wave shaping circuits, clippers, clampers, doublers, a light emitting diode, photodiodes, and protection diode. And finally, we've talked about biasing of a diode, that you can forward bias the diode or reverse bias the diode. And if you want the diode to function properly, it must be forward biased, so that it can allow current to flow only in that direction. So that's all about today's class. See you in our next class.